BTS. The group dominates the multi-billion dollar K-pop industry. It's got 7 members, all known for their colorful haircuts, slick dancing, and record-breaking album sales. So what can we expect from BTS's latest album? Well, watch out for more streaming records to be broken and more stadiums to sell out. While some boy bands struggle with the pressures of early success, this group shows no signs of slowing down. Jeff Benjamin is a K-pop columnist at Billboard magazine, and he joins me now live from New York. Great to have you on the program. Jeff, how are you doing?
I'm doing good. Great to see you again, and congrats on the new show.
Thank you. So I understand from talking to you and looking at what fans are saying about this album that they're hoping it's going to be the dream album. It's also an album where the band's going to reflect on the time that they've had together. So what statement can we expect the band to make?
Right. And I think if you first and foremost look at the title, Map of the Soul 7, that's a really important part of this album. You know, 7 is a really significant number, not only because BTS has 7 members, but this is their 7th year together. It's kind of, I think, going to tie up a lot of stories in BTS's albums. They've had so many stories in their albums, so many different topics that they've ranged on that showed their growth as young men to eventually come to be, you know, these young adults that they truly are. And I feel like they've just learned so much, and there's going to be so many messages that I think we're going to be able to see just how much BTS has changed from those early boys, those bulletproof Boy Scouts you mentioned at the beginning, to now the true artists that they are today.
But some of the changes that we often expect from boy bands, but we haven't necessarily seen this time, are what can happen to groups when they become really successful. The kind of sex, drugs, and rock and roll that we've seen a lot of other groups eventually suffer from. But we don't see the members of BTS partying, having high-profile romances, or behaving badly. How seriously do they take their status as role models?
Yeah, I think what you're kind of picking up on in particular is something very indicative to kind of the Korean music industry at large, for sure. You know, we love, in the West, we love a bad boy, we love a rebel moment. But, you know, scandal is not really something that a lot of people in the Korean industry look well upon. They don't really like a controversial moment. But I think BTS, too, they've always been such hard workers. I think because they've had that underdog status from the beginning. They didn't come from a big company. They didn't start with a silver spoon in their mouth. They always worked hard. They always were kind of always grinding. And there were a lot of people that, you know, kind of didn't necessarily believe in them at first. You know, there you could look at the numbers, and I remember seeing them at their first big US festival in 2014 and just being so amazed by the response that these fans were giving them, and realizing that there was something special here that goes beyond, you know, having big company funds or you know, having the best producers or whatever it is. You know, there was, you know, that underdog status, and I think they've always felt like the underdog and kind of continue to always prove that in their art, for sure. And, you know, rather than wanting to make something, you know, unnecessarily dramatic or controversial, you know, they've kept the goal in focus, and they just keep achieving their goals and keep going even higher than that.
And Jeff, how much creative control does BTS have over their music? How much input do they have over the spectacles that we see on stage and in their videos? It's so creative and so intensely choreographed.
Yeah, and I mean, I think that's one of the most fun things when you watch BTS is that you really do feel like this is an extension of themselves. BTS stuck out really early in their industry for having messages that felt very personal and were definitely internal reflections of themselves. I think you can definitely tell from what we've seen with this album so far. It comes out in a couple hours, but you know, you can definitely feel like this is, like you said, sort of a dream album for BTS. The new single On, it has a very anthemic chorus, and it's something very powerful, very spiritual in that way. And we learned that the guys actually reached out to Sia to personally be on it, and you can kind of hear why she was such a good fit for that. The guys were really, really smart about that, I think. And definitely also being put, they've said that they're fans of artists like Choi Sivan for so long. And Choi Sivan and his team actually co-wrote and co-produced a a song for this album, Map of the Soul, Persona 7, on this record. So you definitely feel like lots of times this is an extension of BTS rather than, you know, this isn't an A&R'd, doctored album made by a label. This does feel like a genuine expression of BTS and kind of where they're at as artists.
It does sound like there's going to be a lot of dimension, lots of different influences, and the world will be listening. Jeff Benjamin, always good to speak to you. You're so enthusiastic about the band, and it's always great to hear your thoughts. Thank you.
Take a listen when you can.
I will.